I will tell you a bit about solutions, how you can produce RDF from MSW independent of your budget, bigger sites, smaller sites. So in this case, we talk about how to produce the RDF and for all budgets, because we know there are different realities on this world. So are there emerging countries which don't have that high tipping fees we have in Germany or other parts in Europe? And the solution has to fit the situation and not the other way around. So I will show you a few plans and I will give you some figures about cost at the end. What's the cost of such a process? We talk about large facilities, roughly 1,000 tons per day and above, which produce high quality RDF. We will talk about medium size facilities, more in the range of 300 to 500 tons per day, also producing high quality RDF. And then the smaller sites, which cannot, for affordable RDF costs, produce high quality, but more the medium or lower quality RDF. And the same is possible on a fully mobile version. So just a characterization for the RDF, what we call high quality RDF. We talk about small particle size, low moisture content, and calorific values between 15 and 20 megajoule, or 3.6 to nearly 5 megacalories. Low chlorine content, and lower biomass content, because the biomass has lower calorific value. This type of RDF can be used for high substitution rates, even in the main burner. And the medium quality, which is then for smaller facilities, has lower calorific value, can be in bigger particles, so you save the last shredding step, and usually contains more than 50% of biomass. So this is more for the lower substitution rates. And my takeaway from Mr. Lechtenberg's last year's alternative fuel symposium was that a lot of cement companies nowadays accept more and more the medium quality RDF because it's cheaper. If we look at the mass balance, and I'm coming from a different region, that is more the waste composition in Southeast Asia with high moisture contents up to 60%. So we talk about 20-25% of RDF, dry RDF at the end for the high quality, and around 30% for the medium quality or less, because if you take out the recyclables to sell, to make the RDF cheaper, it will be, of course, a bit less. So if we talk about the large and medium MBT facilities, it always consists of a relatively sophisticated mechanical pretreatment, relatively highly automated biological drying, and the same for the mechanical post-treatment. So that is designed for large quantities, and it's pretty much automated. If we talk about the smaller sites, an automation in that degree is not possible, cannot be, it's not affordable. So here we talk about cheaper RDF, of course a bit lower in quality, but about cheaper RDF. So even small facilities are sustainable. So the main difference is that we take out quite a fair amount of recyclables to sell, because it makes the RDF at the end cheaper if you can substitute the operation costs by selling recyclables. Drying here can be in a mobile system or in simple windrows which are covered. So if we look at the total cost, we talk about the large facilities, and if you look at the cost, please, that includes civil works, that includes all mobile machines, and of course the processing technology in terms of mechanical and biological. So we are talking roughly 25-26 million euro invest costs for facilities between 1,000 and 1,500 tons per day. We talk about 10 million for facilities up to 500,000, And we are talking about less than 2 million invest costs for the small and mobile facilities, which at the end can process nearly 200 tons per day of household waste. So there are possibilities, especially from Eggersmann, which technology which suits every budget. Thank you.